It's April 7th, 2023, and I'm Todd Dunn, and today I want to talk about your first night at home after total knee replacement surgery. In an earlier video, I talked about the day of surgery and the first day after that when you come home. And today I want to talk about sleeping that first night at home. And I use the walker to get over to the bed, not because I needed it at this point, 5.5 weeks out from surgery, but as a demonstration, because if you come home that first night, you're probably gonna be using the walker. So let's talk about getting into bed. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is, unlike my bed here, which has got the covers laid out on it, you're gonna wanna turn the bed back. And I recommend turning it all the way back, all the way down to the foot of the bed, because you're going to have a lot of trouble getting your feet, particularly the surgical leg, under the covers if you try to slide that leg under the covers. So turn the bed back all the way down to the foot. Next thing you want to do is get into bed. And you're probably going to be using a walker like this, so you want to back up against the bed and then sit down onto the bed. And you want to make sure you sit down far enough up that your feet are not going to be hitting the footboard of the bed. So you'll sit down and you can set the walker out of the way. And you'll notice I'm on the bed so that my surgical leg, which is my right leg, is going to be on the outside of the bed when I get into bed. And there's a reason for that. If I sit down the other way, I have to get this leg onto the bed first, and that's going to be difficult. And when I get off the bed, I'm going to have this leg on the inside, and that's also going to be more difficult. So you want to, sleep so that your surgical leg is on the outside of the bed when you're lying on your back. So now you're going to swing over and get onto the bed. Now, if you did your exercises before surgery and strengthened your leg, you might be able to lift the leg up on its own, like this. However, if your leg isn't strong enough to do that, you have two other options. One, you can use the non-surgical leg to support your leg, hook your foot under your ankle, and lift the leg up. Like that. And the other thing you could do is get somebody to help you by lifting your leg up for you. Anyway, once you're in the bed, you're on your back. And this is how you're going to be sleeping that first night, unless you can figure out how to roll on your side. Now, I found it very difficult at first to roll over onto the non-surgical side. It really hurt the leg, the surgical leg, quite a bit. But it wasn't too bad to roll onto the surgical side. Scoot over in the bed a little and roll onto the surgical side. And I found that it was convenient to bend my knee a little bit. Maybe not very much, 10 or 15 degrees. But if I put the other leg on top of it, that was very unpleasant. And the solution to that is to take a pillow and put it on top of the surgical leg. Now the surgical leg is on the mattress on the bottom. The pillow on top pads it and will distribute weight of the non-surgical leg. And for me, I find it very hard to go to sleep lying flat on my back. Although once I go to sleep, I do tend to roll on my back. But so it's, for me, it's much easier to go to sleep on my side. And I was able to go to sleep like this. Wasn't too uncomfortable, even the first night home. Now, you're gonna be getting up probably a number of times during the night. And this can be an issue if you needed someone to help you get your leg onto the bed. And so you might have to arrange for your partner to be willing to get up several times during the night, if you need to go to the bathroom, for example, to give you a hand getting in and out of bed. On the other hand, if you're strong enough to get in and out of bed yourself, then you will be okay. So let's see about getting out of bed. Okay, first off, I'm gonna scoot over close to the edge. Now, I wanna get the surgical leg off the bed. So I'm gonna put the other leg underneath it and use it to support the surgical leg as I rotate myself around and sit up. And then I can scoot forward a little bit. Like this, pull the walker over, right up against the bed, and stand up. And then you're in good shape. You can go into the bathroom if you need to. Ideally, you have set up your bathroom with some aids for getting on and off the toilet. I put in one of those bathroom grab bars on the side. Like on the wall, which did the job for me. Now, fortunately, my toilet is already on a plinth when we bought the house, so it's a little higher, which made it easier. And some people will have one of those portable commodes that are much higher than a regular toilet that they use, but then you have to figure out how to dump that thing. And I felt it was worth it just to be able to go into the bathroom on my own. Okay, so that sort of finishes what I wanted to say about sleeping and the use of a pillow, wherever I put it, here it is, to put between your knees to distribute the load of the upper non-surgical knee on the lower surgical knee. Now, after you have been home for a few days or maybe a week or more, you might find that if you put the pillow between your knees when you're lying flat on the bed, that you might be able to roll onto the non-surgical side. And if you want to try to sleep that way. So that's, but probably you're not going to be able to do that for, probably took me about 10 days before I could do that comfortably. I mean, I could do it after the first day or two, but other than that, it was very uncomfortable. Now, you've managed to get through your first night. You're probably not going to get a lot of sleep that first night. It's going to be difficult to find a comfortable position, and you're going to have to get up probably. One thing you can do to help you is if you feel that you're probably going to have to get up more than once during the night to go use the bathroom, I recommend that you don't drink any water for about 3 hours before you go to bed. And by drink any water, I mean you can use what you need to swallow your medications, but don't drink a big glass of water because that's just going to go through the system. And the other thing I can tell you is you want to stay on top of your pain medications. If you spent the night in the hospital and came home the next day, probably sometime that evening, if you had a nerve block, it's going to wear off. And you're going to go from zero pain to possibly considerable pain as two things happen. That nerve block wears off, and the medications they gave you in the hospital before you left wear off. So you're going to want to be start taking your at-home pain medications. Now, I found for the first week or so that I was able to stay on top of the pain just by taking over-the-counter medications, acetaminophen and ibuprofen. But I got a little lax and skipped a few doses, and after about 8 days, things kind of went the wrong way, and I was in considerable pain and had a very bad night, and ended up finally filling the narcotic painkiller prescription that I had just not bothered with up to that point. And I took a couple of those, and they do work. Personally, I don't like to take them. I take as few as I can, and I still stay mostly with over-the-counter painkillers. But you do want to stay on top of that, get on a regular schedule. Don't skip doses at first, or you will pay for it. It is much easier to stay ahead of the pain than it is to play catch up. So, as I said, get on to a regular schedule and stick with it. Now, if you do feel that you need to use the narcotic painkillers, well, use them as prescribed. And you don't have enough in your initial prescription to create a dependency, so don't worry about that. Your physicians are aware of that and take that into consideration when they give you that prescription. Now, myself, I have mostly used in the 5.5 weeks since surgery the narcotic painkiller just before bedtime so that I can sleep well. I find it's very effective to take one of those an hour before bedtime so that by the time I go to bed, it's working and my pain is minimal and I can get a decent night's sleep. And that has been the main use I've had for those pills. I think that over the 5.5 weeks, I have taken about 9 or 10 of those pills. So, but mostly at night when I was having a little bit more pain than I wanted and needed the pills to get a good night's sleep, or at least felt that they helped me get a good night's sleep. I wouldn't say that I needed them. Now, another thing. I find, and I have found so far, that swelling is one of the biggest issues you're going to have with your leg. It's going to be really swollen up that first few weeks, couple weeks after you get home. And you're going to be wanting to do your bending exercises. Now, in the morning, when you first wake up, your swelling is going to be at the lowest level probably for the day. So that's a good time to do your first set of bending exercises to work on flexure or flexion of your knee, to bend it as much as you can. And that'll get you through your first knee bending session of the day when the swelling is the least and you have the best chance to get good bending of the knee. The swelling is going to be one of your big barriers to bending your knee. And if you do your first bending session, first thing in the morning, basically before you stand up out of bed, that will allow you to get more bend than if you wait until the swelling has increased later in the day. And it will increase throughout the day. So that's the first night that you're home and sleeping in your bed, and just a couple of pointers. Okay, hope you found this interesting and useful. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and maybe even consider subscribing to my channel to get more content like this. Thank you for watching.